أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
فأخذ الله نكال الآخرة والأولى. So Allah seized him with his punishment of the hereafter as well as the present. He was seized and drowned with his armies. This was the punishment of here, of this world. And then the punishment of the hereafter is the fire of the hell. So these both punishments. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ الْعِبْرَةً لِمَنْ يَخْشَىٰ. Surely in that is a lesson for him who fears. Whosoever has fear of Allah in his heart, then this story of Moses and Fir'aun, there is a lesson in it for them. أَنْتُمَ شَدُّ خَلْقَنَ مِنْ السَّبَاءُ بَنَاهَا. Are you more difficult to be created? Or the heaven that he has built? When man thinks that it is difficult, it's impossible, how we can be resurrected? But what does it mean? They think that the creation of man is greater, harder, more difficult. For that Allah who has created the heavens. أَنْتُمْ أَشَدُّ خَلْقًا. Are you more difficult to create? أَمِ السَّمَاءُ. Or the heaven. بَنَاهَا. He built it. رَفَعَ سَمْكَهَا فَسَوَّاهَا. He raised up high its canopy. And then perfected it. And balanced it. وَأَغْطَشَ لَيْلَهَا وَأَخْرَجَ دُحَاهَا. And he darkened its night and brought out its bright morning. وَالْأَرْضَ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ دَحَاهَا. And after that, he spread out the earth. أَخْرَجَ مِنْهَا مَاهَا وَمَرْعَاهَا. He brought out therefrom its water and its grazing grounds. Everything coming from this earth. We dig a well and take out water from the earth. The tube well is going down and water is gushing out. In the same way, all these pastures, all these gardens, all this vegetation is from the earth. وَالْأَرْضَ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ دَحَاهَا أَخْرَجَ مِنْهَا مَاهَا وَمَرْعَاهَا وَالْجِبَالَ أَرْسَاهَا. And the mountains, he fixed them firmly. مَتَاعًا لَكُمْ وَلِأَنْعَامِكُمْ. Note this ayah. This ayah will be repeated in the next surah also. Because this surah and the next surah, Abbas, they are in the form of a pair. مَتَاعًا لَكُمْ وَلِأَنْعَامِكُمْ. All this is a provision for you and your cattle. فَإِذَا جَاتِ الطَّامَّةُ الْكُبْرَىٰ. So when that great calamity will come, that is السَّاعَةُ. يَوْمَ يَتَذَكَّرُ الْإِنسَانُ مَا سَعَىٰ. That day man will remember and recall what he strived for, what he worked for throughout his life, what was his goals. So actually that day he will recall. يَوْمَ يَتَذَكَّرُ الْإِنسَانُ مَا سَعَىٰ. I spent my life in what pursuits? For gaining what? وَبُرِّزَتِ الْجَحِيمُ لِمَنْ يَرَىٰ. And the hellfire will be made evident for whosoever sees it. فَأَمَّا مَنْ تَغَىٰ. So whosoever exceeded the bounds specified by the Lord, bounds of the Sharia, bounds of the divine law. وَآثَرَ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا. And preferred the life of this world. فَإِنَّ الْجَحِيمَ الْمَأْوَىٰ. Surely then, the fire of hell shall be his abode. Now these two things. فَأَمَّا مَنْ تَغَىٰ. You know, in pursuit of our passions, emotions, our desires, our lusts, this worldly lusts, and so on and so forth, we cross the limits of the Sharia. We cross the limits of halal and haram. And number two, we prefer this life to the life of the hereafter. Now one thing is that you deny that there is no life hereafter, no resurrection. That is kufr of a very high degree. But even if you say, I believe in it, but your attitude in this world is showing that you have preferred this life to that. You are working more for this life than that. You attach more importance to the comforts and gains of this life than that of the hereafter. So this is what is said here. وَآثَرَ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا. And whosoever prefers this life of this world, فَإِنَّ الْجَحِيمَ هِيَ الْبَاوَى. Surely his abode will be the hellfire. وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ. On the contrary, the one who kept fearing and shivering with the idea that one day he will have to stand before his Lord for questioning, for reckoning, وَنَهَا النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى. And he restrained his baser self, the animal instincts, from the desires and mean and lusts and desires of this world. So these are again two. There were two things. أَمَّا مَنْ تَغَى وَآثَرَ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا فَإِنَّ الْجَحِيمَ هِيَ الْبَاوَى. As against that, two things. وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ. Whosoever was fearful that one day he will have to face his Lord, stand before him for the questioning. And as a result of that, وَنَهَا النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى. He pulled the reins of his inner libido from all the things which are forbidden by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَإِنَّ الْجَنَّةَ هِيَ الْمَعْوَى. For such people, the garden is going to be the abode. يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ السَّاعَةِ. But these people, they are asking you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, about that hour, that when it will come to pass, when they had no other argument, the last thing, you know, they should say, okay, when will it happen? Tell us. Or bring that chastisement. But here Allah says, يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ السَّاعَةِ أَيَّانَ مُرْسَاهَا. They are asking you, questioning you, about that hour, when it will come to pass. فِيمَا أَنْتَ مِنْ ذِكْرَاهَا. What concern to you of its declaration? You have no connection with that. This is with us. We shall decide, and we know it. It's not your job to tell people when it will come. إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ مُنْتَهَاهَا. Your Lord is, to your Lord is the goal thereof, or it concerns only your Lord. Only He knows when that hour will come. إِنَّمَا أَنْتَ مُنْزِرُ مَنْ يَخْشَاهَا. Your position, your duty, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is only to warn those who fear it. If they have some fears in their hearts, well, that fear will increase. They will be motivated to take to the right path. So that is your duty. That's your job. كَانَّهُمْ يَوْمَ يَرَوْنَهَا لَمْ يَلْبَسُوا إِلَّا عَشِيَّةً أَوْ ضُحَاهَا. The day they see it, it shall be as if they had but lived in this world for only one evening, or in addition a morning or more. And that's all. All this life, it might have been 80 years, 90 years, 70 years, but it will appear to be an evening, or maybe also the following morning. Now we come to Surah Abas. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Abasa wa tawalla. He, that is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, frowned and turned aside. Anjahu al-a'ma. Because there came to him the blind man. Now the incident in the background is that once the Prophet was busy talking to the chiefs of Quraysh, important people, noble. As we have read many a times, he had more attention towards them, because if they accept Iman and Islam, then you know Islam would be strengthened. And also the plight and condition of the downtrodden Muslims, the slaves, etc., they could be better. If these people who have a high position in the society if they come in the fold of Islam. So that was only the only cause for which the Prophet used to pay attention to them. But it so happened when he was busy, Hazrat Abdullah ibn Umm Maktoum radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and he was first cousin of Hazrat Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha, and he was a blind person. He came and he wanted to address the Prophet. He wanted that the Prophet should listen to him. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam felt it. He didn't like it. I'm busy here and he wants my attention. But because he was blind, he couldn't see the situation. He again tried to address him. On that, there were turns on the forehead of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, frowning. So for displeasure, the sign of displeasure appeared on his face. He, the Prophet, frowned and turned aside. He didn't turn towards Abdullah ibn Umm Maktoum, but his attention was diverted toward the same chiefs. وَمَا يُدْرِيكَ لَعَلَّهُ يَزَّكَّى. And how could you realize that it might be that he might have purified himself? Abdullah ibn Umm Maktoum, he is coming to you, he wants to talk to you. It was just possible that your giving attention to him would have purified him. أَوْ يَزَّكَّرُ. Or he might have got some admonition, some reminding. فَتَنْفَعُ الزِّكْرَ. And the admonition might have profited him. أَمَّا مَنْ اسْتَغْنَى. As for those who is not paying any heed to you, فَأَنْتَ لَهُ تَصَدَّى. You are attending to them very attentively. وَمَا عَلَيْكَ اللَّهِ يَزَّكَّى. And there is no blame on you if they are not purifying themselves. You are not responsible for them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not going to question you. Why didn't they accept your message? Well, the responsibility is theirs. But they are not paying attention. They show there is no inclination whatsoever. But you are trying and trying and trying. وَأَمَّا مَنْ جَاءَكَ يَسَى. And who comes to you running eagerly? He wants to benefit from your company, from your talk, from conversation that he can have with you. وَهُوَ يَخْشَى. And he has a fear of Allah in his heart. فَأَنْتَ عَنْهُ تَلَحَى. To him you pay no heed. كَلَّا. Don't know this. Don't take to this attitude. إِنَّهَا تَذْكِرَى. Verily this Quran is only an admonition and reminding. فَمَنْ شَاءَ ذَكَرَى. So whosoever wants, let him be reminded. Let him be admonished. Let him remember. Fi suhufin mukarramatin. These ayat over here, the majesty of Quran, it is described here, as we have seen, innahu la Quranun kareem fi kitabim maknoon la yamassuhu illa al-mutahharoon. If you recall, in Surah Al-Waqi'ah, then we had, innahu fi ummil kitab ladaina laliyun hakeem. In the same way here, fi suhufin mukarramatin. This Quran is inscribed in records which are greatly honored. Marfu'atin mutahharatin, exalted, kept pure and holy. Bi'aydi safaratin, in the hands of the writers. And who are those writers? Kiramim barara, the angels who are noble and virtuous. So this is the situation, this is the position of this Quran. You don't, don't, so to say, dishonor it by offering in this way. And so to say, you are running behind these rich people and the chiefs, taking Quran with you in your hand or presenting to them Quran. Quran is a very honorable thing. So whosoever wants, okay, he has the right that this message should be conveyed to him. But whosoever feels no interest, no inclination, let him go where he goes. قَتَلَ الْإِنسَانُ مَا أَكْفَرَهُ. That's to man. How ungrateful is he? مِنْ أَيِّ شَيْءٍ خَلَقَهُ. Of what thing, out of what Did he create him? He never thinks. Min nutfa, out of a sperm drop, khalaqahu faqaddarahu. He created it from that and then molded him in proper proportions. Summa sabila yassarahu. Then made the way easy for him. The way, what does it mean? Maybe the process of birth, coming out of the womb of the mother into this world, breathing in this atmosphere. This is also a very difficult way, but Allah makes it easy. Then, you know, passing through this world, there are difficulties. We shall read, إِنَّكَ كَادِحٌ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ كَدْحًا فَمُلَاقِيهِ. But a man is accustomed to it, and then, you know, he passes the whole life. ثُمَّ السَّبِيلَ يَسَّرَهُ ثُمَّ أَمَاتَهُ. Then he made him die, فَأَقْبَرَهُ, and got him buried. ثُمَّ إِذَا شَاءَ أَنْشَرَهُ. And after that, whenever he wills, he shall raise him. Now the former things, which one of those were easy? Creating a man out of a sperm drop, was it an easy job? This birth, do you think it's an easy process? How Allah has, you know, made it easy. Then everything that is going on before your eyes, each thing is very difficult, if you think. Only because you see them day and night. So you think, you take them for granted. But if you think and ponder, everything is very great. And everything is a symbol of Allah's omnipotence, that He has all authority and all power. Summa amatahu faakbarahu, summa idha shaan sharahu. It's the second step, that's all. Kalla lamma yakzima amara. No, but man has not fulfilled what his Lord has commanded him. The Lord has commanded, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. And we made the covenant before coming into this world. أَلَسْتُ بِرَبِّكُمْ قَالُوا بَلَىٰ. But man does not fulfill the covenant. He does not fulfill what God commands him. فَلْيَنْظُرِ الْإِنسَانُ إِلَىٰ طَعَامِهِ. Once before, the attention to your own creation. Now look to the food that you eat. فَلْيَنْظُرِ الْإِنسَانُ إِلَىٰ طَعَامِهِ. Let this man look at his food. أَنَّا سَبَبْنَا الْمَاءَ سَبًّا. It is we who poured down water abundantly. Who brought down the rain? Ourselves. ثُمَّ شَقَقْنَا الْأَرْضَ شَقَّى. Then we splitted the earth in clefts. فَأَبَّتْنَا فِيهَا حَبَّى. And then we made the grain to grow. وَعِنَبًا وَقَضْبًا. And the grapes and the palm trees. وَعِنَبًا وَقَضْبًا. And the grapes and vegetables. وَزَيْتُونًا وَنَخْلًا. And the olive trees and the palm trees. وَحَدَائِقَ غُلْبًا. And walled gardens of dense growth. وَفَاكِهَةً وَأَبًّا. And all sorts of fruits and fodder. مَتَاعًا لَكُمْ وَلِأَنْعَامِكُمْ. Again that ayah repeated. And all this is a provision for you and for your cattle. فَإِذَا جَاتِ الصَّاخَّةُ. Again compare. There was فَإِذَا جَاتِ الطَّامَّةُ الْكُبْرَى in Surah An-Nazi'at. And here it is, فَإِذَا جَاتِ الصَّاخَّةُ. Then when the deafening cry will come out, يَوْمَ يَفِرُ الْمَرْءُ مِنْ أَخِيهِ. On that day, man will run away from his brother. وَأُمِّهِ وَأَبِيهِ. And his mother and his father. وَصَاحِبَتِهِ وَبَنِيهِ. And from his wife and his children. لِكُلِّ امْرَئٍ مِّنْهُمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ شَأْنٌ يُغْنِيهِ. Every one of them that day shall have enough concern of his own to make him indifferent or unmindful of others. This is what we call in some of the tradition, nafsi, nafsi. Everybody will be thinking about himself. And we have read in Surah Al-Ma'arij, يُبَصْرُونَهُمْ يَوَدُّ الْمُجْرِمُ لَوْ يَفْتَدِي مِنْ عَذَابِ يَوْمَئِذٍ بِبَنِيهِ وَصَاحِبَتِهِ وَأَخِيهِ وَفَصِيلَتِهِ الَّتِي تُوْوِيهِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا ثُمَّ يُنْجِيهِ. Take all humanity, put it in hell, please save me anyhow. This will be the condition. But we should think here. We have beloveds, sons, daughters, wives, husbands, parents, and for them, for pleasing them, we do wrong things. We earn through prohibited means. For them, to provide for them a better living, to provide a better education for the children. We indulge in all things, in riba, so that they can have more comfortable, big mansion to live. Okay, go and have in mortgage, have a house. But on that day, you will be thinking about your own self. What should be our attitude here? Here also we should first of all think of our own salvation, then the salvation of others. But there is circle. First of all, you own tu anfusakum wa ahlikum nara, and also your family. Then wa anzir ashirataka al-aqrabin, then a broader circle, your relatives, your kith and kin, then your nation, maybe your tribe, then the all mankind. But this should go in this sequence. Not that you are going and, you know, and calling others to the deen of Allah and forgetting your own family. You don't think where they are going. And you are living happily with them, although their direction is absolutely opposite to the direction of deen. But still your instinctive love for them, that is there. So what will happen? يَوْمَ يَفِرُّ الْمَرْءُ مِنْ أَخِيهِ وَأُمِّهِ وَأَبِيهِ وَصَاحِبَتِهِ وَبَنِيهِ لِكُلِّ امْرِئٍ مِّنْهُمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ شَأْنٌ يُغْنِيهِ. Now again we have here a picture of the day of resurrection, as we had in Surah Al-Qiyamah. In the same way, وُجُوهٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ مُّسْفِرَةٌ. Many faces on that day shall be beaming, shining, glittering, glaring. ظَاحِكَةٌ مُسْتَبْشِرَةٌ. Laughing, rejoicing. People who believed, and because every nafs, every soul would be knowing where it stands. بَلِ الْإِنسَانُ عَلَىٰ نَفْسِهِ بَصِيرًا. Although it has not been declared, but they know it. What is going to be declared for us? So those who are going to be successful, declared successful, already on their faces, you find, you know, those signs of success. وَوُجُوهٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ عَلَيْهَا غَبَرَةٌ. Many faces on that day shall have dust upon it. تَرْحَقُهَا قَتَرَةٌ. Darkness will be overspread over them. أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْكَفَرَةُ الْفَجَرَةُ. Those, they will be the disbelievers and the miscreants. Now, a pair of two surahs, Surah Al-Takwir, Surah Al-Infitar. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إذا الشمس كورت. This surah is very peculiar, that the scene of the as-sa'ah, what will be happening, you know, what will be the turmoil, the kafiyat of that turmoil on that day. إذا الشمس كورت, when the sun will be wrapped up. وإذا النجوم انكدرت, and when the stars will fall and lose their luster. وَإِذَا الْجِبَالُ سُيِّرَتْ, and when the mountains will be made to move. وَإِذَا الْإِشْهَارُ عُقْتِلَتْ, and when the 10 months pregnant she camels will be running here and there without being taken cared of. You know, 10 months pregnant she camel was a very valuable thing for the Arab Bedouin. So he used to take very care of it. But no, today, that day, nobody will have any thought of that sea camel. That will be running in this side, this side. وَإِذَا الْوُحُوشُ حُشِرَتْ, and when the beasts were be herded together, that day will be that even the beasts, they will forget that their function is to prey and kill and eat. No, no. They'll be standing. As if stunned, they will be herded together. Vaizal Biharu Sujjirat. And when the seas will boil and swell, Vaizal Nufusu Zuvijat. And when the souls will be reunited. But the interpretation of this reunion of souls, we have two opinions. One is from Akrama and Hasan Basri, rahimahumullah. That is, they will be reunited with their bodies. When we die, our souls are separated from our bodies. The bodies go to the earth, decays. But now on the resurrection, these souls are united again with the bodies. These bodies will be new. New bodies will be given, and now the souls will be reunited. Just as in the wombs of the mother, after 4 months, that soul, that spirit is brought by the angel and united with the embryo in the womb of the mother. In the same way, on that day, the souls will be reunited with their bodies. But from Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, the opinion is that the souls will be grouped in different categories. There are different categories of disbelievers, different categories of the believers. Among the believers there would be prophets, messengers, then the Siddiqeen, then the Shuhada, and so on and so forth, Awliya Allah. So they will be grouped accordingly. And in the same way, among the disbelievers and the enemies of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there are different grades. وَإِذَا الْمَوْوُدَةُ السَّوِلَتْ And when the girl child buried alive is questioned, بَأَيِّ زَمْبٍ قُتِلَتْ For what sin of her she was slain and buried alive. This was the custom with the Arabs in that jahiliya, that they were very much ashamed when they were told that a daughter has been born to them. And most of them used to take the daughter and bury it alive, dig a pit and put her in it and then throw the sand over her. So now, instead of saying that the people will be asked, why did you bury your daughter? No, the scene is that she will be asked, due to what mistake of yours you were slain? وَإِذَا الصُّحُفُ نُشِرَتْ And when the records of the deeds, they will be laid open. These are your records. اِقْرَى كِتَابَكْ كَفَى بِنَفْسِكَ الْيَوْمَ عَلَيْكَ حَسِيبًا وَإِذَا السَّمَاءُ كُشِطَتْ And when the heaven is stripped off, laid bare. وَإِذَا الْجَحِيمُ سُعِرَتْ And when the hell will be set ablaze, وَإِذَا الْجَنَّةُ أُزْلِفَتْ And when the garden is brought near, عَلِمَتْ نَفْسٌ مَا أَحْضَرَتْ On that day, every soul shall come to know what it has sent before for itself. All his deeds are there. فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَهُ وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَهُ Every soul will come to know that this is what I had sent before coming to this world. I had already sent these deeds of mine here. Now the second part of this surah, it discusses the same issue which is discussed in the beginning of Suratul Najm. Sight of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam that he saw Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam in his original angelic form twice. Once on the ufuq, on the horizon, and once in the Sidratil Muntaha on the night of the ascension, Miraj. So this the same issue is, because most more important issues are, as a rule, discussed in the Quran at least twice. So here, there, you know, Vardajim started with the oath, one najm iza hawa. Here also you find, فَلَا أُخْسِمُ بِالْخُنَّسِ الْجَوَارِ الْكُنَّسِ وَاللَّيْلِ اِذَا عَصْعَصْ وَالصُّبْحِ اِذَا تَنَفَّسِ I swear by the receding stars, moving swiftly and hiding. And I swear by the night when it departs, وَصُبْحِ إِذَا تَنَفَّسْ, and by the morning when it breathes, starts breathing, you know, because activity is going to start after the morning, as if morning is breathing. إِنَّهُ لَقَوْلُ رَسُولٍ كَرِيمٍ. Verily, surely, definitely, this is the speech of a noble messenger. And here by the noble messenger is meant Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam. In Surah Al-Haqqah, the noble messenger, إِنَّهُ لَقَوْلُ رَسُولٍ كَرِيمٍ, was Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we have read in Surah Al-Hajj, اللَّهُ يَسْتَفِي مِنَ الْمَلَائِكَةِ رُسُلًا وَمِنَ النَّاسِ. So this is word of God, word of Allah. From Allah, it came to Jibreel. From Jibreel, it came to Muhammad. And from Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, people knew it. So this is the speech of Jibreel also. And we can say this is the speech of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because it came out of the mouth of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It was not sent down, written on anything. It was sent on his heart. And the people came to know it through the mouth of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So it is called of Rasul. But both are Rasul. Jibreel is Rasul number one. He is the Rasul from among the angels. And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is Rasul number two. He is the messenger from among the human beings. إِنَّهُ لَقَوْلُ رَسُولٍ كَرِيمٍ ذِي قُوَّةٍ عِنْدَ ذِي الْعَرْشِ مَكِينٍ. There we hear Zumurratin Fastava Summa Dana Fatadalla Fakana Kaba Kausani Awadna. These were the, you know, condition of Hazrat Jibreel described in Surat al-Najm. Here, Ziquwatin in the Zil Arshe Makin. He is endued with power and he has a high position near the Lord of the throne, Zil Arshe Makin, Muta'in Samma Amin. He is obeyed by the angels. And at the same time, he is trustworthy. Whatever message is given to him, he conveys it exactly in the same form. وَمَا صَاحِبُكُمْ مَجْنُونَ. And your friend, your man, that is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The same word came in Surah Al-Najm. مَا وَلَّ صَاحِبُكُمْ وَمَا غَوَى. Your man, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he's from amongst you. He's a Qarshi from the tribe of Quraysh. And he has not gone mad. And here, مَا صَاحِبُكُمْ بِمَجْنُونَ, he is not possessed. No evil spirit has possessed him. He has not gone crazy. وَلَقَدْ رَآهُ بِالْأُفُقِ الْمُبِينَ. He saw the angel, Jibreel, at the clear horizon. وَمَا هُوَ عَلَى الْغَيْبِ بِضَنِينَ. It has been interpreted in two ways. He is not miserly in conveying the unseen. Whatever knowledge of the unseen comes to him, he conveys to the people. He is not miserly, doesn't keep it to himself. And the second meaning is, he is not the seeker of the unseen. He doesn't want that the unseen should be disclosed to him. It is being disclosed to him by the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has appointed him as a messenger. وَمَا هُوَ بِقَوْلِ شَيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ. Anyhow, this is not the speech of an accursed Satan. فَأَيْنَ تَذْهَبُونَ. So where are you heading? Where are you going? إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا ذِكْرٌ لِلْعَالَمِينَ. This Quran and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, both are nothing but an admonition to the worlds, to all the peoples, all the nations of the world. لِمَنْ شَاءَ مِنْكُمْ أَنْ يَسْتَقِيمُ. To whomsoever of you who wills to go straight, whosoever wants to take to the straight path, for him this is the guidance. وَمَا تَشَاءُونَ إِلَّا أَنْ يَشَاءَ اللَّهُ. And your wishing will also be of no avail unless Allah also wishes. You want to do something? Allah gives the permission, then you can do it. So even your wishing and your deciding something is not sufficient, but Allah's permission is required. illa an yasha Allah Rabbul Alameen, except as Allah wills, the Lord of the worlds. Now the second surah of this pair is As-sama, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, As-sama'un fatarat. Now here, these ayat, this depicting the condition of that asa, are limited in number. Four. There we had so many. But here, very brief. As-sama'un fatarat, when the heaven will be split asunder, وَإِذَا الْكَوَاكِبُ انْتَصَرَتْ, and when the stars will be fallen and scattered, وَإِذَا الْبِحَارُ فُجِّرَتْ, and when the seas and oceans are flowed out and dried up, وَإِذَا الْقُبُورُ بُعْصِرَتْ, and when the graves will be overturned, عَلِمَتْ نَفْسٌ مَا قَدَّمَتْ وَأَخَّرَتْ, every soul will know what it sent forward and what it left behind. I described it, explained that these are the two aspects of our deeds that we are doing in this world. One is that we are sending before going to that world, during this lifetime, whatever we are doing, it is going ahead of us. But when we die, we leave something. The legacy is there. Maybe we have left something very good, and it is very beneficial for the people. Maybe you have established an institution from which the people are benefiting and getting the knowledge of Quran. So this will keep on giving you credit in the books of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is what you left behind. Maybe you left your sons and daughters as good Muslims, good Mu'mins. And so this, they will be, which we call Sadqa Jariya. This is actually a virtue that will continue. So every soul will come to know what it had forwarded beforehand and what it had left behind. Ya ayyuhal insanu ma gharraka bi rabbikal kareem. This is the third place in the Quran, then this concept is discussed. O man, what has seduced you regarding your Lord, the Gracious? This is a very effective and very dangerous, you know, attack of Satan. He says, okay, go on doing what you are doing. Allah is forgiving. Allah is merciful. Don't worry. Go on. Continue. So what he's saying is true. Allah is merciful. No doubt. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us, he is very strict in punishment also. Both things have to be kept side by side, simultaneously. And there should be a balance. Bain al-khawf wa al-raja. Otherwise, you will go to this way or that way. You will leave the straight path. It's necessary that you should have hope. Allah will do try as best as you can. And then hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whatever the shortcoming, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive. But also keep the fear, maybe, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punishes him for that. So Satan would say, go, do harm. Allah is forgiving, Allah is merciful. Ya ayyuhal insan, ma gharraka bi rabbikal kareem. What has beguiled or seduced you concerning your gracious Lord? Allazi khalaqaka fasawwaka fa'adalak. Who created you, then fashioned you, then proportioned you rightly. Fi ayya suratim ma'ashara kabak. Into whatever form he willed, he composed you. Whatever features he wanted, he gave you. So, he has done all these things for testing you. And what is the use of testing? If all are going to be forgiven, what's the use? This is all exercise in futility. No. كَلَّا بَلْ تُكَذِّبُونَ بِالدِّينِ. If you are thinking in that way, actually you are belying the reward. مَالِكِ يَوْمِ الدِّينِ. He is the authority on the day of judgment. But judgment, What's the use of judgment? If there is forgiveness for everybody, then what this judgment for? And what this trial? And what this test? Everything becomes absolutely meaningless. Kalla bal tukazzibuna biddeen. Nay, but you are belying the reward. Wa inna alaykum lahafizeen. Although we have put over you appointed guardians, kiraman katibin, surely over you are appointed guardians who are noble writers. You have two of them. They are writing everything, recording everything, every deed of yours, every action of yours, every word you utter being recorded. Kiraman katib. What for then? If no reward is to be given, if no punishment is to be given, then why this? Inna labrara lafi na'im. Surely, people will be divided on that day. The pious shall be in bliss, who fulfilled their covenant with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, their creator and their master. They will be in bliss, in blessings. Wa innal fujjara lafi jahim. And surely, the miscreants, the transgressors, those who were disobedient to their Lord, they will be in the hell. Yaslawnaha yawmaddeen. And they will enter it on the day of judgment. This is the yawmuddeen, which we say in Surah Al-Fatiha, Maliki yawmuddeen. Wama hum anha bighaibeen. And once entered it, they will not be absent from it. They will have no place to run, no place to hide, no place to have any refuge. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا يَوْمُ الدِّينِ. And what will make you realize, how can you imagine what this day of judgment is? ثُمَّ مَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا يَوْمُ الدِّينِ. Again, how can you visualize, how you can understand what this day of judgment would be? How grave, how hard. يَوْمَ يَجْعَلُ الْوِلْدَانَ شِيبَدِ السَّمَاءُ مُنْفَطِرٌ بِهِ. That day, يَوْمَ لَا تَمْلِكُ نَفْسٌ لِنَفْسٍ شَيْئًا. The day when no soul should be helpful for another soul. Nobody will be helped to help either his father or mother or son or daughter or wife or husband. No, nothing. يَوْمَ لَا تَمْلِكُ نَفْسٌ لِنَفْسٍ شَيْئًا. No soul will have any power to be helpful for the another soul. وَالْأَمْرُ يَوْمَئِذٍ لِلَّهِ. And the authority and command that day will be exclusively in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just as we have read before, it will be shouted, called, لِمَنِ الْمُلْكُ الْيَوْمِ لِلَّهِ الْوَاحِدِ الْقَهَّارِ. To whom belongs the sovereignty today? In the world you said you are sovereign. But to whom belongs the sovereignty today? لِلَّهِ الْوَاحِدِ الْقَهَّارِ. Sovereignty today belongs to only Allah, who is alone, Al-Wahid, Al-Qahhar. Surah Al-Mutaffifin. This and Surah Al-Inshiqaq, which comes later, they are a pair. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. وَيْلٌ لِلْمُطَفِّفِينَ. Woe to the mean defrauders. You know, if somebody is selling something and giving by mayor, and he is not filling the mayor to its full, so he's defrauding the purchaser. But how mean it is. How much can he gain through it? In the same way, somebody is, you know, weighing something to give to his customer. And you know, he gives a jerk to his hand. And he will gain something, but what? How much? Maybe a few grams in a kilogram, that's all. So actually mean defrauding. Not a big fraud. Not a very big gain. Very small gain. This is tough. Mutaffifeen. Who are selling their faith for very, very, very small price. وَيْلٌ لِلْمُطَفِّفِينَ. Woe to the mean defrauders. الَّذِينَ إِذَا اكْتَالُوا عَلَى النَّاسِ يَسْتَوْفُونَ Who, when they take mayor from the people, they take full. When they are taking something, someone else is mayoring something for him, he takes full. وَإِذَا كَالُوهُمْ أَوْ وَزَنُوهُمْ But when they mayor for others, or weigh for them, يُخْسِرُونَ They diminish it. أَلَا يَظُنَّ أُولَٰئِكَ أَنَّهُمْ مَبْعُوثُونَ Now this is to be pondered over carefully. This small action, but it shows something very big. It means he doesn't know or he doesn't believe that a day is to come when he will be resurrected and he will be questioned for each and every deed of his. The deed is very small, but what is this denoting is very big. أَلَا يَظُنَّ أُولَٰئِكَ أَنَّهُمْ مَبْعُوثُونَ Don't they think that they shall be resurrected and raised up? لَيَوْمٍ عَظِيمٍ On the might day, يَوْمَ يَقُومُ النَّاسُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ The day when the people will stand before their Lord, before the Lord of the worlds. The whole mankind will be standing for that accountability, for that reckoning. كَلَّا إِنَّ كِتَابَ الْفُجَّارِ لَفِي سِجِّينَ Verily the records of the miscreants will be in Sijjin. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا سِجِّينَ And what will make you realize what Sijjin is? كِتَابٌ مَرْقُومٌ A register inscribed, written. وَيْلٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ لِلْمُكَذِّبِينَ Woe that day to the beliars. Now we have read this. وَيْلٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ لِلْمُكَذِّبِينَ It was repeated 10 times in Surah Al-Mursalat. وَيْلٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ لِلْمُكَذِّبِينَ Woe to those people who belied the messengers on that day. الَّذِينَ يُكَذِّبُونَ بِيَوْمِ الدِّينَ Those who belie the coming of the day of judgment. They say no day of judgment is coming. وَمَا يُكَذِّبُ بِهِ إِلَّا كُلُّ مُعْتَدٍ أَثِيمٍ And nobody belies the day of judgment except the one who is rebellious sinner. Only the rebellious and the sinner, he says that no day of judgment will be coming. إِذَا تُتْلَى عَلَيْهِ آيَاتُنَا قَالَ أَسَاطِيرُ الْأَوَّلِينَ Whenever ayat are recited unto him, he says, Oh, these are the fables of the ancient. Kalla. Nay. Bal. Rana ala qulubihim ma kanu yaksibun. Actually, what they have been earning has made their hearts rusting. There is rust on their hearts. And that is why they can't see. And they can't understand. And they can't See that these ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are haq. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-azim wa nafani wa iyaakum bil ayat al-hikm al-hakim.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar.
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having 4 levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tenzim.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us or call our toll-free number 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together we can make a difference.